Thanks for tuning in. The local share market's going to kick off in negative territory this morning. The futures are telling us that we'll be down by a little less than 0.2%. So unable to capture the wellspring of optimism that we saw for US markets overnight. There were gains that saw US indices propelled to new record highs. So a gain of around 0.6% for the S&P 500 and the Dow Jones. The NASDAQ was up by around 0.4%. So there are a number of different influences on the market yesterday. So from a fundamental level, the earnings picture, we had Goldman Sachs numbers reported by the investment bank. The shares finished up by 2.6%, having delivered substantially better than expected earnings. So that was a part of the reason why we saw banks generally do quite well last night on the US market. The KBW Bank Index was up by about 1.7%. JP Morgan, Wells Fargo, Citigroup, Morgan Stanley, they were all up in the order of around 1-2%. There was a bit of a stutter in the previous session as far as financial names were concerned, so it was a return to the positive side of the ledger last night. Elsewhere, Apple shares were an example of the optimism in the tech space, or the large cap technology space. They hit a record high, the shares, and part of the reason being is that there have been some broker upgrades, with analysts encouraged by the prospect of a new upgrade cycle being driven by AI functions on Apple's handsets in particular. So Apple shares were up by about 1.5%. We also heard from the US Fed Chairman Jerome Powell. He was speaking at the Economics Club of New York, and in the statements that he made, he spoke about the fact that US interest rates, where Fed funds are concerned, don't necessarily need to be at or below 2% before the Fed starts cutting. It's not the first time we've heard that sentiment from Mr. Powell, but going hand in glove with the fact that the Fed has a little more confidence these days when it comes to the trajectory for inflation, the markets were encouraged by that. But in terms of the move for interest rates last night, a two-year Treasury note down slightly to about 4.4%, but there was a bit of a bump higher for longer dated bonds. So a 10-year Treasury note up by 10 basis points to 4.55. A little bit of discussion about what Trump presidency means as far as the outlook for budgets, spending, and indeed how that all boils down to inflation. So that is all in the context of a groundswell as far as Mr. Trump's candidacy is concerned following the events of the weekend. So overnight he announced a running mate in terms of a vice president. That has been very much the topic in the political conversation, but the market's focus has been on what a Trump presidency might look like, and it was a traditional response in terms of a law and order piece that was driving the various sectors higher. So for example, you saw gun makers do quite well last night. So Smith & Wesson shares were up by about 12%. Private prison operators did quite well, so Core Civic and Geo Group up by about 9%. They are operators in that part of the business. Energy stocks also did quite well on the belief that a Trump administration would be supportive for your traditional energy setup. So contractors like Halliburton, Baker Hughes are doing quite well. Devon Energy and Schlumberger up, they were all up in the order of around 4% last night. So they were some of the factors that contributed to the US improvement. European markets were a slightly different picture. We had stocks generally weaker, so they had done quite well over the course of previous sessions. In recent days, they'd risen anywhere between 2 and 3%, so a consolidation, I suppose, last night. The UK market down 0.8%, the French market down 1.2%, the German market down by about 0.8%. I suppose one thing that did stand out in the European experience was the underperformance where mining stocks were concerned. So that was a reflection of what we saw yesterday with underwhelming economic figures out of China. So that cast a pall over mining stocks in Europe. So it's a question to what extent that residue remains where local stocks are concerned. So we had oil prices moderate overnight, down by about a half of 1%. Gold slightly firmer, but not by much, up by a third of a percent. And the Aussie dollar trading at 67.6 US cents. A pretty thin offering today in terms of corporate or economic news, but Rio Tinto will be announcing their quarterly production numbers, so that'll be something of a highlight. And we continue to await details out of the Chinese third plenum. This is the forum in which they discuss the prospects for the Chinese economy and any growth initiatives that might come out of that will certainly be received with acute interest when it comes to mining stocks in particular at the moment.